In 2016, a woman brought me a mirror that she described as very angry. She said that some sort of dark entity had emerged from the mirror and savagely attacked a member of her family. She also told me that she had inherited the mirror from her uncle, who was a criminal lawyer and aspiring movie producer. He claimed it once belonged to Bela Lugosi, the actor famous for introducing Count Dracula to American movie audiences. Now, allegedly, Lugosi was fascinated by the occult, and it's possible that he may have used this mirror for scrying. And if he did, perhaps he opened up a portal that remains active to this day. The woman also told me that in 1982, her uncle was brutally murdered in his home and that the perpetrator of the crime was never caught. Now, if the mirror captured the reflection of that murder,
Gracie, I'm gonna need you to pick up all your toys. Look at this. Everywhere. Look like an Easter egg hunt. You need to pick them all up, put them in the basket.
Ever heard of a clown motel in the middle of a desert? We decided to drive 8 hours to stay the night. It would prove to be one of my worst ideas ever. The manager let us pick our room since nobody else was staying here. Every room feels evil. It makes me uneasy. We decided to go with the most haunted room. That was our biggest mistake. The manager then showed us his huge clown collection, including this giant clown that moved on ghost adventures. This place just screams evil. Little did I know, it was about to get worse. They were all waiting for the night so they could come alive. Come back to see what happens at night. Part 2. We got some food and came back to our room at night. It's absolutely terrifying. These paintings almost feel as if they are alive. I swear some of them even watch you. We decided at 3 a.m. to go to the graveyard right next door. Things immediately feel off and I feel watched. I don't feel good about this. We are gonna go into the graveyard in part 3. Wish us luck. I don't want to. This doesn't feel right or safe. It's 3 a.m. and we are in a graveyard near the clown motel. Everything was going fine until I heard a child call my name. It sounded close, but so far, the full moon is making things worse. We used a ghost radar and the thing got weird. We decided to follow the app and see where it would lead us. We heard more noises and the words on the app got more specific. It took us to a grave, said the words to, and we found a burial site with two children. We got back to the hotel to find our door wide open and a clown toy on the bed. WTF.
After returning from the graveyard to our room at the Clown Motel, we found the door open with a clown doll on the bed. We didn't think too much on it and decided to go to bed. I also made sure the door was thoroughly locked. I live-streamed us sleeping and woke up and found that there was a ton of stuff that happened during the night. What really haunted me wasn't until we left the Clown Motel and got on the road. A viewer sent me this photo from the bathroom. If you zoom in, it looks like a clown is standing in the bathroom. Once the photo was overexposed, it was even more haunting. It looks like a clown face. Let me know what you guys think down below.